In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to digitize your artwork. Something that I get asked a lot is how to turn traditional art into digital art or a digital file. It's pretty simple. There are just a few things you need to know, and I'm going to show you how to do that right now. First thing you're going to want to know is how to get that piece of art into your computer. And the second thing is how to clean it up. And the third thing is how to export it into different kinds of files that you can use for different reasons. There are a lot of reasons why you might want to digitize your art. You might want to sell prints. You might want to make merchandise, t-shirts or stickers or whatever. Or you might want to just have something nice and clean to post on social media or your website. For whatever reason you want to do this, I'm going to make it as easy as I can for you. So this is going to be for people who don't have a scanner, who would rather take a photo, just get near a window. As you can see, I have nothing fancy. This is just a little spot by the window. So you just slap this guy down on the floor, position the phone so that it's parallel to the artwork, line up the top, the bottom, and the sides of the artwork with the lines on the phone. Now, if you're seeing a bit of a shadow on your artwork, you can always just lay that guy straight up and then snap a photo, but just make sure that the phone is parallel to the artwork.
Once you've taken the photo, head over to your desktop or laptop. Use your phone charging cord to connect your phone to your computer.
With Photoshop open, let's go up to File, Open, and then navigate over to your phone and find where your photo is and open that photo up in Photoshop. Now, if you want to scan your artwork, this is super easy.
All you got to do is throw that bad boy into the scanner, scanner on in, open up the scanner software, and export the scan as a JPEG or a PNG.
This is the scan. The scan has quite a bit more detail. If you look at the photograph, quite a bit more detail. I'm gonna actually work on the scanned image because it has so much more detail, but everything that I do the scanned image, you can also do to an image that you took on your phone. The first thing I wanna do is crop out the scan lines here. And in order to do that, I'm gonna come down here to this little crop tool, or you can just hit C, and I'm gonna come up here to the little dimensions and click on this dropdown and hit square so that it keeps the dimensions square no matter how I adjust it. And I'm gonna hold Alt as I click and drag one of the corners so that it stays centered as I scale it. And then once I have it kind of where I want it, I'm gonna go ahead and hit enter. So I cropped out those scan lines. Everything looks really good, the perspective. But if you would like to adjust your perspective, if it's sort of wonky, just go ahead and unlock that background layer if it's locked and hit Control or Command T and then right click within that square and you'll see a little option called perspective. Click that guy. And then if you use any of these little corner points, it will adjust the perspective. So if it's like looking like this because you had it at an angle when you took that photo, like I told you not to, then you can go ahead and adjust it with this perspective tool. I'm gonna go ahead and undo that. And I'm gonna hit escape to get out of that tool. So I've got my image cropped pretty much how I want it. Actually, I might go ahead and scale it up a bit to get rid of that space on the right side, which I'm just, again, Control or Command T, and then I'm just clicking and dragging these points to scale it up. Hit enter. Now there's like little scratches and things. I'm gonna get them out of there. I don't want them, I don't need them. We're gonna get rid of them. I'm gonna come over here to the spot healing brush tool. So just click that guy or you can just hit J. And then I have this little circle here is my brush size. So I can do the little details like that. Or if I wanna just do it more quickly and paint with a broad brush, you can use these bracket keys. The left bracket key will make it smaller and the right bracket key will make it larger. And the way that I'm zooming in and out and panning around is I'm holding Alt or Option and scrolling my middle mouse wheel up or down. That takes me in or out of the image. And then I hold down the space bar and I left click and drag to pan around like that, okay? So that's just how I'm navigating. So again, I've got the spot healing tool. I've got the brush the size that I want it. I'm just going around and clicking and dragging on all of the parts that I want to clean up. The larger the size of the brush, like the more stuff you're gonna get. And Photoshop's pretty smart about knowing what you want and what you don't want. Clicking all the parts that I don't want. Getting them out of here. We don't want them. You can't sit with us. When you do a scan, you get all kind of little fibers and things from the real world. Just be adjusting your brush size as needed, using the bracket keys. If you plan on cutting your image out of the background, you don't have to worry so much about these little details. Only worry about the details that are within the part that you plan on cutting out. If you are going to cut them out, I've got an entire tutorial on how to cut things out from the background. That'll be really helpful for you. A lot of the time you're gonna want that background removed if you're making like die cut stickers or enamel pins or things like that that are gonna be in the shape of your artwork. I'm not going to explain how to do that here, but if you want something with a transparent background, you're gonna wanna cut your subject out and export it as a PNG. So let's talk about exporting and the different files that you're gonna wanna use for different purposes. Let's say that I wanna make a poster. I'm just gonna come up here to File and I'm gonna hit Save As. Save it if you save things to the cloud, go ahead and save it there, but I save things usually to my computer. I'm just gonna save it as a JPEG and just title it whatever you want, like for poster. And then this is honestly up to you. I usually do anywhere from 10 to 12 for the quality. If you're going to make a large poster, I would suggest saving it as a large file. Now let's say you're gonna print this thing like super huge and you need it to be really high quality. In a lot of cases, you're gonna want a vector, but for something like a watercolor like this, it's not always gonna look good as a vector. So in this case, you're gonna wanna save it as a PDF. PDFs work really well for print. A lot of times if you get like a t-shirt or a banner or anything like custom made from printing companies, they're gonna ask you for a PDF. In order to create a PDF, all you gotta do is come down here, File, Save As. Again, save it wherever you wanna save it. And then just click this drop down here. Come on down to Photoshop PDF. Save that guy. It's gonna ask you what you wanna do. Like, there are all these options. We can do like high quality print. You can do smallest file size. You can also do press quality. Typically, I go with high quality print if I'm gonna print something with a PDF. And I don't even really adjust anything here. Save that guy. Say yes. Now, if I did cut out that background, like I did here for these stickers, I would want to make sure that all this little checkered space from where I cut it out is transparent in my file. In order to save out a file that has transparency, all you do is come up here, File, Save As, and then click the drop down and save it as a PNG. Okay, that's pretty much it, man. Thanks for watching. I hope I made it nice and easy for you. I hope now you can take your artwork, digitize it, and turn it into something really cool. You can do all kinds of things now that your artwork is in the computer, on the internet, in the world of digital stuff. You should definitely try this at home with your own art. You're just gonna wanna make sure the perspective is right. Crop that bad boy, use a spot heel, clean that baby up. And don't forget the exporting options. For a lot of things that you wanna print, like merchandise and things, they're gonna want like a PDF or even like a vector file. I'm gonna make a tutorial on how to do that. For anything that has a transparent background, again, use a PNG. That'll be the one that you'll want. And then if you're just gonna like post something or put it on your website or whatever and you're not worried about the transparency of the background, just use a JPEG. So I think that's it. If you need help with anything at all, just leave a comment and I'll do my best to reach back out to you and help you out. Until next time.